So hi, hello, and welcome again. Microbehunter here. Well, today I'm going to put those two Valentine cookies, which I received today, I'm going to put them under the microscope, of course. But I think I need to explain you a little bit first the whole background. You might already know that I'm a teacher. I'm a biology teacher in school, and today's Valentine's Day, and they did a charity drive, our students. And look, they ordered me a Valentine, as a matter of fact, two of them, Valentine cookies to Microbehunter. I put a sticker over here to keep the name of the student a little bit of a secret for privacy reasons. And over here, yeah, a cookie for the best microbiologist we know and adore. Enjoy your cookie. Thank you very much for your cookie. To those of you who send it to me. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to unpack those cookies and I'm going to put them under my stereo microscope and look what I've got here. This here is a slime mold, and I'm also going to be feeding both of these cookies to my slime mold, and then we're going to see whether it prefers the chocolate cookie or the non-chocolate cookie. But we won't be able to figure that out today, because it does take a day for the slime mold to choose the cookie. So this will be a follow-up video. So what I'm gonna do first is, of course, I'm going to unpack it here, and we're going to put it under the stereo microscope. It's probably maybe also under the compound microscope. Let's try to make an investigation also under the compound microscope. Oh, it's a little bit fragile. Okay, doesn't matter. I'm going to leave the rest in here. That's a really nice chocolate cookie. Let's put it under the microscope first and let's have a look. Yeah, so that's the chocolate cookie now under the microscope. Yeah, I mean, yeah, of course, a lot of things to see. That's the chocolate here. It's a little bit blurry because it's much higher up, but let's refocus. Maybe I'm going to flip it around on the backside, because maybe it's a little bit more flat here. That's basically the bottom side here. Looks pretty much very similar to when it's not magnified. Of course, we can try to zoom in a little bit here. I'm kind of losing the focus every time when I zoom in. But that is the chocolate chip cookie. So now let's try the other one as well. So let's open it. So carefully remove it. Here we go. Okay. Yeah, there's also some chocolate here. The students really spend a lot of time baking those. So let's put it also under the microscope. Here, look, nice chocolate pieces in here. So I think what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to take small pieces of both of these cookies, and I'm going to try to feed my slime molds. And then we have to be patient a little bit, and maybe tomorrow or the day after tomorrow, I'm going to able to report back which one of those two cookies the slime mold likes to eat most. So yeah, so that's a slime mold. You can see there are some cereals in the center, and those are yellow, thin branches that you see here. That's slime mold. So, and let's put first the white cookie here, and also the chocolate cookie over here. And then let's see which one of those two the slime mold likes to eat most. But I have to add a little bit of water as well. So a tiny drop of water here and over here as well. Yeah. And I think we're just going to have to be patient now. But let's put it also under the microscope. So what we expect now over the next couple of hours is that the slime mold will now start to devour the two cookies here. Yeah, that's the chocolate one. Yeah, and we're just going to wait a little bit. So now to the compound microscope, let's take a little piece of the chocolate here, and let's try to put that under the microscope. It's not so easy because it's fairly hard, but with a little bit of patience here, I was able to scratch off a tiny amount of chocolate here. So let's put it on the microscope slide. Cover glass goes on top. No water this time, because chocolate does contain a lot of fat. So fat and water do not mix properly. But what I would like to do is I would like to simply squeeze it a little bit here. And then let's see if we're able to see something interesting here. Yeah, maybe warming it up would also sometimes help a little bit. But I think it's going to be thin enough. And let's have a look. Yeah, so I'm going to melt the chocolate a little bit to make it a little bit thinner. And I think we're going to get a nicer image this way. We have to wait a little bit now. It's still still, yeah, slowly maybe. Slowly it's starting to melt. Yes, it's much better. Yeah, I think I can't get it any thinner than that. Yeah, so that's the chocolate now. This is an air bubble, of course. But honestly, I have to tell you, they're probably more interesting specimens than chocolate. Yeah, it's a mix of probably some chocolate butter and sugar and I don't know what, right? Yeah, but in any case, still, at least now we know what chocolate looks like under the microscope. But I think we're going to just move on now. So here, that's one of them here. And from down here, I'll take the other one. And what I'll do now is I'll put the cover glass on top directly, and then I'm going to add the water afterwards under the microscope. So here is the cover glass, and maybe I'm going to press it down a little bit just to make it a tiny bit flatter. It goes under the microscope now. Yeah, so that is essentially one of those crumbs under the microscope. Here is the other one. I think that's the chocolate one over here, right? What I'm going to do now is I'm just going to add a little bit of water and let's see what happens. So here we go. Let's give it a little try. And water is slowly approaching. Maybe a little bit more. Yeah, and slowly the things start to dissolve as well. Yeah, so after I added a little bit of water, I was all of a sudden able to see that there are these round structures here, yeah, which started to come out. The black, dark area here, that is the actual cookie, but then all of a sudden it started to release those round things here. What could they be? Well, at first, my first impression was, well, maybe these are some kind of some fat or oil droplets. Yeah, maybe some of them are, but they look very, very similar to starch grains. Because, of course, there's a lot of flour in those cookies, and those starch grains now seem to have been released into the water here. Yeah, so quite a nice little specimen that we see here. You can see that as the water is spreading, some of the liquid is still flowing a little bit. If I touch this, let's see if I were able to mix this a little bit more. Yeah, and look, yeah, this looks these look very much like starch grains that are now released from the cookie. Well, I think I'm going to call it a day today. Thank you again very much to my students who sent me the cookies. And happy microbe hunting as always. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.